have this problem too. You go into a store looking for just one little thing. But as you walk through the store to find that one item, you pass all of the other new items. And almost without warning, you have a cart full of new items and you're heading to checkout. And then you remember, you never grabbed the small thing you came in for in the first place. Anyone else? Just me? Look, wanting more and more stuff can be a problem. Lots of people live their lives constantly in search of more. More stuff, more money, bigger houses, nicer bikes or cars or clothes, and the list goes on and on and on. They want this stuff when they have perfectly good stuff where they live and could just upcycle or refresh it and give it new life. That's why this month, we hope kids start to understand something about contentment, learning to be okay with what you have. In other words, you may not be happy with what you have or the circumstances you find yourself in, but because of what God has done for you, you can choose to shift your focus away from what you don't have and towards what God desires to do with the life you do have. Actually, the Bible gives us great ideas about contentment and examples of people who had every opportunity to be content, but they were focused on themselves and lost sight of what God was doing. So they became focused on the wrong thing and they lost their contentment. We kick off the month with Paul and something he wrote about contentment to the church in Philippi. Paul wrote that he has learned to be content no matter what circumstance he was facing, which was pretty amazing to say considering he was writing this while he was under house arrest. Bottom line, God can help you be content. Next, we'll check out King Ahab and what happens when he doesn't get something he wants. A guy named Naboth owned a vineyard that Ahab desperately wanted. His wife, Queen Jezebel, took matters into her own hands and at Naboth's expense gets Ahab that vineyard. Ultimately though, this is a case of be careful what you wish for. Ahab and Jezebel ended up with a terrible consequence. Bottom line, wanting more and more can make you miserable. Next, in Exodus, we find the Israelites focusing on what they used to have instead of focusing on God. As they were traveling in the wilderness, they longed to be back in Egypt where they had food and shelter. And at the same time, they seemed to forget that in Egypt, they were slaves. They were so caught up in what they used to have that they were missing out on what God was doing in their lives right then and there. Bottom line, don't miss out on what you have now. We finish up the month in 2 Corinthians 8. Paul writes to the believers in Corinth and tells them about the churches in Macedonia who donated freely even though they were very poor. For the Corinthian church and for us, this is a great reminder that no matter what we have or what we've been through, we always have something to give. Bottom line, you can always use what you have to help someone else. See, when it comes right down to it, contentment, it's a heart issue. It can't be solved by getting the thing that's off limits, the thing that someone else has, or even more of a good thing you already have. The solution for being content is trusting God in all circumstances. That's why we want to challenge kids this month to memorize something Jesus said. Luke 12:15 says, "Then he said to them, watch out, be on your guard against wanting to have more and more things. Life is not made up of how much a person has." See, contentment happens when we put our trust in Jesus. He's the one who's able to meet our needs each day. And really, if we trust God, there's not only no need to worry about tomorrow, there's no reason to be distracted by what others have or what's off limits or what we had in the past. When we really trust God, we will be content with exactly what we already have.